Good evening, this is Melissa with the Stock Swish, and I'm going to go over a gap that happened on Friday. This was SHLD, S-H-L-D. Sears, this gap happened actually Thursday night, and I woke up in the morning on Friday and I saw it, and it actually fell more before the open than where it actually set up and traded. I had no idea that this thing was going to run in the way that it ran today. I think it was $8 for the whole day's run. Look at that thing. Unbelievable. Just unbelievable. $9. Almost $9. This is the power of gaps. This is the power of momentum. This is the information that I teach how to find these things in my class, The Golden Gap. How to find these things so that you know how to play them. Okay? Let's just look what happened with this chart. I'm opening it up. I'm showing you the whole thing here, okay? What happened here? Now, let's just go back here. This day, this was back in February, the stock had a bullish gap up. This is a bullish gap here. Gapped up, rallied out. It looks like it's going out to new highs here. But I got to be honest with you, this is just an area of a retest up here. Remember, these things are areas. This is only a retest of an area right over here. That's all that happened. It popped a little bit over it. And then it came in. Okay? Now, we had another bullish gap that happened right here in the end of April. It was beginning of May? Yeah, 4:30. No, it was 5:01. September, May 1st. It should have held itself on this one. First of all, it should have held itself on this one. It didn't. It for sure should have held itself on this one. This is a monster bar here. This is almost a $10 bar on this day, and it's a bullish gap up, but it can't hold itself. Look at this. Look at this. Look at it. It is really struggling here. What is the problem with this thing? This day, it should have ran like the Dickens and went all way over here enough to really vindicate this the move that it was going to stay up, but obviously there was a problem. This came up and just retested this area. This came up and just retested these areas. This came up and retested. This is a resistance. And even here today, don't get suckered into this. You think all of a sudden we're breaking out because we went over this. This is where you have to really get, you have to learn how to read charts. I don't know what to tell you. You got to take my class. Okay, you need to know how to read charts. You need to become a member of my room. You've got to read this stuff for what's really happening here. I know it went over this area. But one green bar does not an uptrend make. Okay? What happened? It just dinged down and went down here and sat right on the 200. And when we gapped down today, we crucified this. We killed this thing. We just absolutely said no. No way. And why is this a surprise? It's really not at all. It's not a surprise whatsoever when you look at the bigger picture here. Do you see this? And look at where it went for the target. It actually went under the target a little bit. The target was 46.28 and it went down to 46.13. Went 15 cents under the target. I don't know if you could have even gotten this whole thing. This is just, you never know for sure this is going to do this. You have to have targets all along the way here. Okay, and then you're up so much money with these kinds of moves. Position it down. Take your pivots and keep marking it down to hold it down to get this trade. These are monster moves. You don't have an expectation you're even going to get this whole thing once you're in it. You just play it out, okay? You just play it out. But it fell. Here's a 15-minute. Do you see how this thing dropped and fell? It actually fell all the way down into 245 here. I like to play the morning. I get the morning. I get the maximum move I possibly can in the morning. Sometimes I take a later play. Sometimes I take a later play into lunch. Sometimes once in a blue moon, I'll play in the afternoon. But I really just like to play the morning and stop. That's just me personally what I like to do. But this thing actually had a nice, clean 15-minute sell setup here. I'm looking at this now. Let me see here. I mean, I could have retaken this in the afternoon, but look. Really nice. 48.37, 48.33. You could have taken this. You could have taken, oh, let me see this one here. 48.30. Okay? You could have taken this. This was a valid trade into this 15-minute sell setup drop. I'm not crazy about this one here, and I don't like this one here either. Okay? There's no guarantee when this thing drops like a rock that it's going to keep going forever. I know that it did today, okay, but there's not high odds of it doing that. It just proved how weak this thing was, how weak this thing was. One green bar here, and how weak. Every time it had a green bar, it had another red bar to wipe it out. Every time it had a green bar, it had another red bar to wipe it out, and look at them, they get the drop. I just, what is the top of this? 49.30, yep. This was good too. You could have taken this too. This is pretty tight here. Pretty exact to get in right there. Okay, so you could have got in right there. And then you could have added right here. And you could have gotten this whole drop down. This actually set up for this is normally a whippy stock, and it really set up clean. Really set up clean here in this 15 minute to get it. But the maximum move was in the morning. From the time that it opened at 54.72 in the morning move down to 10 o'clock, is to 48.61. This is, you know, 60-70% of the move it's going to make on the day. This is what I teach in my class. This is what you got to get. This move. If you get the rest of this, these are second or third plays that you should be taking after you're ready up money on the day. Okay? I want you to focus on the morning. But by the time this thing starts going, it has so much momentum under it. You see the power of the gap that it just is taking everybody out. So first of all, big money positions are getting out of it, and then day traders or traders are shorting it. So there's all kinds of things going on. Everybody creates this bar. This is everybody. This is huge, large amounts of money of big positions, institutions shorting or selling out of their positions, and then there's day traders too, and then it just pushes it. Okay? And that's what happened to create this. In fact, this happened even despite the market trying to rally back on Friday. How did we close? Yeah, we did. We had a push up then, even later in the day, into the close, and Shield kept going lower. So it just was proving its weakness. At the time that first one was setting up, let's see, this is 11:30, and we got that hard drop into 245 when we were actually doing a 15-minute buy setup here. So it was weak. It was very, 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 very weak. Here's where it was. Yeah, this was doing the 15-minute sell setup into here, where the market was rallying up. So it was great. It was really, really good. This is where you want to get this. This is what you have to get. If you can learn to do this and you're ready up money on the day, you can get these second and third moves. But I like to see them precise. I'm not doing anything with this one here. I like to see this one, and I like this one here. These are clean, nice rallies into resistance. And another rally into resistance to take the drop. At some point, though, you're going to have to get out of this trade and book your money. I'm all out in this first half hour of the day. But then take it out as it goes down. This ended up being extremely, extremely, extremely good. This is beautiful. Anyways, this is Melissa with thestockswish.com. I am doing a trading room starting the end of this month. If you're interested, please feel free to contact me at info@thestockswish.com. Have a great night.